Hi guys, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well, hope you've been having a great day, and I hope you're going to be having a fantastic week ahead. If you're in the UK, we've got a bit of sunshine, maybe, hopefully, for you, and it feels like spring is just about on its way now, which is fantastic. I hate winter. I love spring. I love summer. Not big fan of autumn, but definitely spring and summer, my favourite times of year. So really glad to be back. Had a few laptop glitches last week, and which were very, very strange and a little bit disturbing. Anything that affects my laptop, it usually kind of drives me insane for a while. So I had to run a few tests on it, and fortunately, I'm not really sure if I actually did anything to fix it, but it hasn't recurred. So touch wood, hopefully any updates that I've made on the laptop have worked. So that said, it's nice to be back. It's nice to be doing some reactions. And this is a track I'm about to react to. I think it might be a live version as well. So hopefully, touch wood, I won't get blocked. Anyway, this is by Robert Palmer. It's called Johnny and Mary. And it was on the album Clues from August 1980. It was a non-charted track. So, written by Robert Palmer. So without further ado, I'm looking forward to this. I'm trying to think of the last one I reacted to. I think it may have been like a ballad type one. I can't think what it was called. I've also reacted to Looking for Clues, which was pretty cool. I liked that one. So I think I've reacted to maybe two other Robert Palmer tracks so far. Anyway, this is Johnny and Mary live at Balinge Bifest 1980. Really good beat to this so far. It's really chill.
Johnny says he's willing to learn when he decides he's a fool. Johnny says he'll live anywhere when he has time. Here he comes ahead. Says she should be used to it. Mary always hedges her bets. She never knows. But it still acts like he's being discussed. Scared that he'll be caught without a second thought. Ooh, running around. Wasting his breath, trying to talk sinister. He says he's lacking a real sense of proportion. So he knows he tires easily. Johnny's always running around, trying to find certainty. He's all the world to confirm.
Sorry if this video seems to be glitching as well. I'm not sure whether it's just buffering or something, but I do apologise for that if this does come out on the finished edit. I'm actually really liking his his t-shirt. I'm trying to think. 1980. I didn't think that barcodes were out then, but clearly that is a barcode on the front of his t-shirt, which is really, really cool. It's just mad to think then that barcodes have been actually used for the last 40 plus years. It's mad. Sorry, I should talk about the record really. This is really, really cool, very atmospheric. I love the different keyboards and synths that just kind of creating this whole sort of tapestry of sound. And obviously this is live, so it doesn't sound like it's perfect, but not having heard this track before, I would imagine that I need to probably listen to the studio version as well. Just like to hear his voice, and he's got such a smooth voice as well, which just very relaxing. I actually find this track is really, really chilled and relaxing, but the synths are very, very good. I think he likes that microphone. Really enjoyed that. I really loved the way it just kind of started to fade away then, and the instruments kind of broke down at the end. But it was a really, 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 really nice track, and again, just a great, great vocals from Robert Palmer. Never heard this before. It's different to Looking for Clues. Here, there's a bit more kind of vocal on that, but this was just like using his voice very gently, and The organ and the synth, the Yamaha, I think it was, and it was very nice. They're playing off each other, and at the end, they got two guitars playing off each other. So yeah, it's a really, really cool track. I think this might be about a relationship breakdown. I think just from the lyrics I picked up, Johnny's always running around trying to find certainty. He needs all the world to confirm that he ain't lonely. Mary counts the walls, knows he ties easily. Johnny thinks the world would be right if I could buy the truth from him. Johnny thinks the world would be right if it could buy the truth from him. Mary says he changes his mind more than a woman, but she made her bet even when the chance was slim. Johnny says he's willing to learn. When he decides he's a fool, Johnny says he'll live anywhere. When he earns time, to Mary combs her hair. She says she should be used to it. Mary always hedges her bets. She never knows what to think. She says that he acts like he is being discovered, scared that he'll be caught without a second thought, running around. It doesn't really sound like a very healthy relationship, let's be honest. Johnny feels he's wasting his breath trying to talk sense to her. Mary says he's lacking a real sense of proportion, so she combs her hair, knows he tires easily. Yeah, the kind of like, I'm not really entirely sure what the lyric's about, but I kind of feel that he is basically quite insecure and he's not really kind of settled. And yeah, she's not really kind of buying it. So it's like it feels like a breakup of relationship where he doesn't really know how to act. She doesn't really know how to take him. But this was good. It was very fascinating watching a live performance. And I can't really think there's anything. That microphone was really weird as well. I don't think he looked like he was enjoying singing into it, like a very sort of square edge. Very, very strange microphone. I don't think I've ever seen a microphone like that. Let me just see if I can... Yeah, I loved that T-shirt with a barcode, so I need to kind of find something out. So just bear with me 2 seconds. Okay, so barcodes actually came out in the early 70s, but they weren't used until later in the 70s. And the first barcode apparently was used on a packet of Wrigley's chewing gum, and that was in the US, and that was in 1979. It's just amazing to think that barcodes have been around that long. That's crazy. And this barcode looks very modern as well, so it doesn't look like any different to the barcodes we have today. That's really, really crazy. Let's have a look, see if there's any comments on this. Have a quick look. Yeah, Robert was an underappreciated as a musician in the 1980s. I think he certainly was. I think he had a few big hits and then Nothing Like a Band and Zero Fake Instruments sounds. This is priceless. Makes it feel like Robert's still alive. A sad and beautiful song that makes me tearfully miss the unique moment I had with my lady when it came on the radio by chance. And mourn loss of genius that created the masterpiece. I think I need to listen to this a little bit more. But I love the melody of it. I love the synths and the guitars. And I think sometimes when you start to put the sounds together and then you can listen to more of what the lyrics are talking about in the context, and it has a deeper meaning. Clearly people see that deeper meaning here. I have fits of missing him at least quarterly. Close-knit, classy band here. Keyboards or synths drive this song. A one, if not Robert Palmer's best song to the greatest decade of all time. I mean, you know, it's amazing really that I'd never heard of this song, and yet it sounds like the kind of song that could have graced the UK Top 40. Why this didn't chart, I'll never know. You know, clearly it's a very intricately woven song with the instruments, and yeah, it's got that kind of like catchy reprise of like singing Johnny and Marie, Johnny and Mary. I don't know why this never charted. It's just, it's one of those mysteries. I hear songs like this. It's a little bit like, why didn't Michael Cimbello's Maniac chart in the UK in 1983? It didn't. I think it was released, but it just didn't do any good. And yet it was number one in the US. And it was an incredible track. And this is a pretty cool track as well. And I don't think there was a massive amount. I mean, the big synth hitters didn't really kind of come out until later. I suppose Spandau Ballet came out, then Depeche Mode and Duran Duran. That was all sort of like at the end of this year, beginning into, and then going into 81. So there's no reason why this shouldn't have charted. I don't even know if this was released either. But anyway, it was a really, really nice track to listen to. I'm definitely going to now listen to the studio version to see how that matches up to this. So my apologies if anyone loves this song, but they don't love this live version. Sometimes the live versions can be very accurate. Sometimes they can be a little wayward. I'm not really sure where this sits, as I haven't actually heard the original. So please join me in the comments below if you have any thoughts about this song. Any feelings? Did it bring back any memories for you of 1980? I'd love to know what you was doing in 1980, if you heard this track, where you heard it and what you was up to. So yeah, till next time, take care of yourselves. Have a wonderful week.